This is a production of PBS 39.
How many of you have been to the St. Patrick's Day Parade in Dublin, Ireland? Probably not too many of us. I know I haven't. Well, a group of students from Freedom High School in Bethlehem not only saw the parade, they were a part of it. Crystal Fisher tells us more.
Start cutting the curls.
Mom, why don't you start?
A few snips, and Matt Truscott's golden curly locks fall to the floor of Freedom High School in Northampton County. You don't usually hear the buzz of a razor in band practice, but today Matt's settling a bet.
I made a bet with Mr. Moran, and I was like making a bet with the devil, and I lost it. So I had to cut my hair because we won first in Dublin.
I said, Matt, that's entirely up to you if you want to do that. He said, well, it'll pump everybody up. It'll motivate them, you know, to really want to do very well. I said, okay, that's okay. If you want to do that, that's fine.
Mr. Moran and Matt have slightly differing stories about how the bet came to be. But no matter what, Matt lost his mane after Freedom High School took home the award for best overall band in the St. Patrick's Day competition in Ireland.
We performed in two parades, one in Limerick and one in the city of Dublin itself.
Their saxophone player wasn't convinced they'd take home a victory at the big event. They were competing against 22 bands from around the world.
I was thinking that we wouldn't win because it's like Dublin, it's big, and we're just a small band, and yeah, I was surprised.
The band has more than 140 members. 116 of them actually went over to Ireland along with 5 coaches, 80 friends and family, and 15 chaperones, including the principal, Michael Laporta.
It's a huge job. Far beyond what I ever imagined it would be, from assisting the band director, the assistant band director, and coordinating students in a large international airport, from the whole landing process to locating luggage to making sure we follow our time schedule.
It was quite an undertaking. We had 5 coaches with us the entire time.
Coordinating the large group, they say, wasn't easy, but it was definitely worth the experience.
The parades were really exciting because there were so many people there, and especially in Dublin. The Limerick parade was like a warm-up. We didn't expect there to be so many people. And then in Dublin, the street was like really small. We didn't have much room to march because they moved the fences in so far just so that like everyone could like fit in. They were like hanging off like lampposts and fountains. There were people everywhere. It was just really awesome. It was really exciting. That was really cool. I mean, how many times can you say you perform for the president of a country?
Twins Melissa and Allison Ruth play important roles in the band as the president and drum major.
They're just a close group of people, and like they're all my friends. So the band trip was awesome because it's just like 100 of your closest friends and you going to Ireland, you know. So it's a good experience.
An experience that didn't just include marching down the streets of Ireland, but left time for them to get out and see the sights.
When we went sightseeing, we saw a lot of castles, because there's a lot of castles there, and we got to go shopping a lot in like little towns, and especially in like Dublin, things like that.
They all agree, though, the best part was winning.
I was very proud for our school. I was very proud for our students, for our band directors and our parents who have put just an enormous amount of time and effort in preparing our students for this event.
But the win didn't come without hard work. The band displays multiple shells of award proving their dedication. Senior Alyssa Clark's been playing the piccolo for her entire high school career.
This room is my second home. I'm not gonna lie. I'm here every day for at least a good 4 hours.
The band rehearses nonstop. They're here very early in the morning. It's just a nonstop organization, and they work very hard.
But the time and hard work doesn't discourage them.
That was probably my favorite part about Freedom High School, was being in the band. Our band is actually, especially this year, is a really close group of people.
The seniors in this close group are heading off to follow their future goals, some in music.
I'm going into music education as of now.
As the seniors leave and grow as artists and musicians, Matt's growing hair will be a reminder back at Freedom for the band to keep marching on to more victories. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.
And just a little side note, as I understand from parents and chaperones who went along on that trip, those students couldn't have been any more well-behaved. Congratulations on your wonderful accomplishment and your great acts.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA CareerLink Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers. And workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
and by the members of PBS 39. Thank you.